Sarasota, Florida is home to the Ringling Museum. It's the former property of John Ringling, who was one of five brothers to start what became the Ringling Brothers Circus. The property has so much to see, and in my last video, I showed you around the Tibbles Learning Center, which is on the property. The Tibbles Learning Center, which you see in the shots here, was named after Howard Tibbles. He loved the circus when he was young, and this inspired a massive project where he remade what went into the circus with these figurines. He spent 50 years making these models, and it is such a unique museum. I recommend watching that video if you haven't seen it yet, because there's a lot of detail and a lot of information in it. Today, I'm going to show you John and his wife Mabel's mansion, as well as the breathtaking courtyard and the art museum. And yes, all of these things are in the same Ringling Museum. This place is humongous. A few things to know before you go is that there are a few different museum admission options. We chose the museum admission, which includes entry to the Museum of Art, the Circus Museum, and Bayfront Gardens. Basically, the only thing that this admission doesn't include is entry to the mansion named the Catazon. This admission is $25 per adult, and there are discounts for teachers, military, and college students. It's an extra $10 for admission to the Catazon. You may also purchase admission for just the grounds and the gardens for $5. Finally, on some Mondays, admission to the Ringling Museum is free. On those Mondays, you just have to pay for the Catazon if that's something that you're interested in. But regardless, you can always walk around the Catazon. So it's not like it's totally like off grounds, you just can't go inside. Before we visited, I read reviews and saw that many people mentioned that they spend an entire day here. I foolishly didn't believe them, and now I totally see how this would be possible. In my last video, I shared that we were overwhelmed by the Circus Museum, and I mean that in a good way. It just was so much information that it was difficult to take in much more after we saw that Circus Museum. This is actually a great thing. I love leaving a museum feeling like I've learned something, and I only mention this so that you can plan your day accordingly. I'm going to talk about the mansion in a second, but before I do, a lot of the background clips while I talk about the mansion will be of this landscaping. The landscaping across the property was absolutely beautiful. They take such good care of it, and it's amazing. Now let's get into the mansion. Not literally, because we didn't buy tickets to enter the actual mansion. The name of the mansion is the Catazon, and I do believe that I'm saying that correctly, but I feel like I'm not. So bear with me a little bit as I say the Catazon. We will definitely pay to enter the mansion next time, but even seeing the outside of the mansion was absolutely breathtaking. It was incredible. The mansion is a very popular place for weddings, and I can definitely see why. John and his wife Mabel purchased 20 acres of waterfront property in Sarasota in 1911. This gives you an idea of how massive the grounds of the Ringling Museum truly were. So they started spending their winters in Sarasota, which back then was a small town. Mabel loved Sarasota, and both John and Mabel were active community members. As time went on, they kept buying real estate, and at one time, they actually owned more than 25% of Sarasota's total area. The Catazon was John and Mabel's mansion. The long walkway here led up to the mansion, and this is where John and Mabel would greet their guests. They hosted at their house often, and throughout the years had many notable guests who visited them. So the mansion was designed by Dwight James Baum, who was a famous New York architect. Even though he designed it, Mabel oversaw every single step of the process and was very involved. Mabel had kept a portfolio with sketches, postcards, and photos for inspiration, kind of like a Pinterest board. She knew she wanted a Venetian Gothic style of the Palazzi in Venice, and Sarasota would serve as kind of her grand canal. It took 2 years to build the $1.5 million house, which was 5 stories tall and 36,000 square feet with 41 rooms and 15 bathrooms. This doesn't have the happiest of endings for John. Mabel eventually passed away, and he was absolutely devastated by her death. The Depression followed not too long after, and John fell into debt. Because of this, it took over a decade to settle his estate. The state eventually took over his estate, but it needed a massive amount of repairs. Of course, the buildings on the property eventually did get the care they needed, and additional buildings were added, such as the Tibbles Museum. Otherwise, it wouldn't be open today. So I'm going to leave you with some video footage of the amazing Catazon. John Ringling used to travel through Europe to find acts for his circus. Along the way, he started to acquire art, and over time, he built quite a collection. The more he collected, the more passionate he became. Soon after they completed the Catazon, John built a 21-gallery museum where he would display his paintings and art objects. He opened this to the public 2 years after the death of his wife in the hopes that this would promote art education and art appreciation. John left it to the people of Florida 5 years later when he died. I think you'll notice that the building itself is an amazing work of art, as well as the breathtaking courtyard in the middle of the museum. It was honestly so beautiful. I hope you enjoyed visiting the Ringling Museum with me. I'm not really sure what expectations we had, but I do know that they were far exceeded. These videos were so much fun to make, and the Ringling Museum was so much fun to visit. I love John and Mabel's story, and I hope that you do too. We drove through Bradenton, Florida in order to get to the Ringling Museum, and that actually inspired a trip to Bradenton, which will be our next video. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. And as always, thank you so much for traveling with us.